train is moving. Today is October 1st, 2023, and we're at Busch Stadium, and we're here for the final game of the season for the Cardinals, but it is also Adam Wainwright's final game ever. He's the main reason we're here, to see him honored today with a ceremony and get to be here for his last time as a Cardinal. It's going to be an awesome day. Excited about this?
Yes. Yes. Go Cards.
Yes. These were our giveaways, an Adam Wainwright guitar. Looks cool. And a calendar for next year's games. This is a 21-inch playable guitar. There's his picture. He's also a singer, not just a pitcher. Oh, that's cool looking. He's got his number on it. Nice.
Every single person that came here and had a dream.
She
city. I love being a St. Louis Cardinal, and I love that I got to play my whole career here. Thank y'all so much for embracing me. I love you.
Connecting with a Christian baseball mission called Impact, he was invited to play baseball and attend school in California. In two seasons at Capital Christian High School in Sacramento, he batted 509 and was drafted by the Boston Red Sox. After stints with the Red Sox, Giants, and Brewers, he was traded to the Houston Astros.
You know, grew up in a very tough environment, but I think that's the reason I got to do this. I think that's the reason I'm able to have success.
In the Fall Classic of November 2022, Mauricio and the Astros defeated the Philadelphia Phillies, making Mauricio the first Honduran-born player to become a World Series champion.
His first career to win games, shutout. Wainwright, his 39th birthday, he goes the distance.
Teammates, coaches, managers, and obviously Hall of Fame.
the man of the hour. He's sitting beside his family. Please welcome the Wainwrights, Adam, Jimmy, Bailey, Morgan, Sadie, and Kay. And Macy. Don't forget Macy. What a day it is, Macy. Thank you. And sitting behind them, Adam's mom, Nancy. Adam's brother, Trey. Jenny's parents, Mimi and Jim. And two special men and Adam's wife, Steve Hammond and Don Christensen. And please welcome the guest list of men that have meant a lot to Adam throughout his journey in baseball and life for the past 2 decades. Friends and teammates, Jaime Garcia. Standard, Jim Westbrook, Wayne Looper, Shane Robinson, Kelly Johnson, Jason Markey, friend and community partner Scott Leibler. In addition to his guests on the field, please join us now in welcoming more of Adam's friends, family, celebrating for the Sweets in 213 and 214. Welcome to this great day. And back on the field at Busch Stadium, Cardinals chairman of the board, Mr. Bill DeWitt Jr. Cardinals president, Bill DeWitt III. President of baseball operations, John Mazzella. Since his call-up in 2005, Adam has had the privilege of playing with 5 Cardinals Red Jacket Hall of Famers. Please welcome these Cardinal Hall of Famers here today to help us celebrate Adam's great day. Teammate Jason Isringhausen. Cardinals and the Baseball Hall of Famer teammate Scott Wibble.
to the proclamation. The proclamation reads, whereas the city of St. Louis is proud to join with the St. Louis Cardinals to recognize the legacy and historic career of professional baseball player Adam Wainwright, and whereas Uncle Charlie will be forever remembered by fans in St. Louis as one of the most popular players in team history, whose leadership, competitiveness, cheerfulness, and love for the game was revered by teammates and opponents alike, and led him to become the third most winningest pitcher in Cardinal annals. And whereas, on behalf of the people of St. Louis, it is my great pleasure to celebrate the legendary career of Adam Wainwright and honor him as one of the great ambassadors for the St. Louis region and baseball fans worldwide. Now, therefore, I, Tashara O. Jones, Mayor of the City of St. Louis, do hereby proclaim October 1st, 2023, to be known as Adam Wainwright Day in the City of St. Louis. Distinguished group here today to honor Adam Wainwright, beginning with the Cardinals chairman of the board, Mr. Bill DeWitt Jr.
Thanks, John. For 19 seasons, Adam Wainwright has worn the birds on the bat with pride, dignity, and competitive fire. The ace of the staff, leader of the clubhouse, two-time 20-game winner, three-time All-Star, four-time top three Cy Young finalist, an MLB record, 325 starts, together with Yadier. A 200-game winner, and what a moment that was, to cap off his career. Pitching seven innings, in a 1-0 shutout. With 140-plus years of Cardinals history, Adam ranks third in wins, innings pitched, and winning percentage. And he ranks second in quality starts and strikeouts. He's pitched in two National League Wild Card Series, seven Division Series, five National League Championship Series, and two World Series. These achievements on the field are elite major league accomplishments, but off the field and in the dugout, he's in a class by himself. He's honest and sincere after wins and losses. He keeps the clubhouse atmosphere positive and uplifting. He connects with everyone, from the rookies to the veterans, from the support staff to the coaches to the front office. Today is bittersweet because a wonderful chapter comes to a close. But first and foremost, today is a celebration of a man who gave everything he had to this franchise and this community. Adam, I am confident your next act will be equally successful as you take the music world by storm or join the broadcasting community. Throughout the world. But remember this, you will always be welcome back home. He is an all-time great St. Louis Cardinals. Thank you very much.
Now let's hear from Cardinals President of Baseball Operations, John Mazzella.
I thought you were saying new ball. I'm asked about Adam Wainwright. How best to describe him? Competitive, I've never met anyone who hates losing more than him, which refers to baseball, golf, fantasy football, or any other game he might play, even with his kids. Talented. We know what he did on the mound. We hear what he can do behind the mic, either on stage or in the booth. Frankly, there is nothing he cannot do. Optimistic. Even when things are not going well, he would tell me he was just one pitch away from being great. And you know what? He believed that. As we stand here today, a page will be turned, and we will begin a new chapter. As we reflect back on his 19 years in the big leagues and what he meant to the St. Louis Cardinals organization, we know this, you will be missed. You always made me smile. I will miss hearing you. Hi, Mr. Love. You made us all smile. During your time here, we are all grateful for what you did for this organization and what you meant to this city. Wayno, most of all, I'm grateful to call you a friend. The best to you and your family. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Cardinals Hall of Famer, Cy Young Award winner, and World Series champion, Chris Carpenter.
for all the journeys on the field that we spent together, but I ultimately think the most important thing is that I love him. His friendship to me means the world. I know that he's going to do great things. I mean, he's proven that no matter what he's doing, he's great. Jenny, I hope you can deal with all the free time. This is going to drive you nuts. Kids, you have two amazing parents to look up to. People that care about human beings, that care about people. I tell my kids all the time, it doesn't matter what you do. It's how you leave it and how you touch people. And he touches people all over this world. So I know that he'll continue to do it. I'm looking forward to spending multiple years when he gets to put on this red coat every day when we come back. And I'm looking forward to his next chapter. I love you, Adam, and go on.
Last year at this time, we celebrated the great careers of Yadier Molina and Albert Pujols. And Adam Wainwright came to the podium to talk about those wonderful careers and the times he had with those two wonderful gentlemen. And in return, we call Albert Pujols to the podium on this day.
Winning the
shine. And thank you for continuing to wear and mentor all those young guys over there. So bless you. Bless you, Jenny. Good luck to you guys. The head shot to the line. Love you, brother. Thank you.
What would a farewell ceremony be without parting gifts, right? Please welcome to the podium the president of Cardinals, Bill DeWitt III.
Thanks, John. Before I present the gifts, I'd like to just say what a pleasure it has been for me to get to know Adam over these many years. We've heard all about his excellence on the field and in the clubhouse and in the community, but I'd also like to note that he's been generous with his time in helping us on the business side of things. Promotional support, doing great funny commercials to help us sell tickets and promote the club. It's very meaningful for working staff to have a good like that, so thank you. The first gift is actually a holdover from last year. And Adam, after you and Yanni set the battery record last season, after the year ended, we didn't really have an opportunity to get you two together. So today, we'd like to present both of you the silver Tiffany bowl that has a Cardinals logo and an inscription on it. If you guys would go over there together. The inscription on the bowl reads, and it's the same for both, presented to Adam Wainwright and Daddy Urbana by the St. Louis Cardinals, commemorating their record-setting 328 starts as a battery on October 2, 2022. The next one, Adam, one of your passions is to give back, and you've done so much in the St. Louis community. But we also know that you're passionate about areas in the world that are severely impoverished, particularly in Latin America. So we connected with Scott Linebrink, who is here today with Water Mission, and who you have worked with before on mission projects. Scott and Adam, if you would step over there next to that red banner. Kat, would you please do the honors? Shelby? So the Cardinals, along with Cardinals Care, are donating $100,000 for a water well and filtration project in your community. Is in El Progreso, Honduras, and it will provide clean water service to approximately 1,500 people. The next gift, Adam, you probably could have predicted, especially given our fan giveaway item today. Alyssa, can you pull that one out of the box? We contacted your producer, Gary Baker, to get a recommendation on a guitar. He suggested a Gibson Les Paul that you would want to rock. And we found an artist, Greg Stump of Axis Paint, to paint it with the Cardinals logos. And on the back are images of personal notes to you that your kids wrote themselves. Be personal for you. And I have a feeling you're going to do this for a good year. The next gift Next page. Next up is kind of a personal one for me, Adam. As you and I have discussed, we both love what we do in the game of baseball. We also have other interests and passions. Your big one is country music. So you decided to learn how to play and write songs and just get out there and do it. And that has been inspirational to me with my side interest of painting and learning how to be an artist. You will recall last year I recruited an artist to do a cool modern portraits of Yachty and Albert as their guests. But this year, in that spirit of just going for it, just like you did last night, I decided to paint this picture myself, not the one that just fell. Shall we please do the honors? So I hope you like this original Bill DeWitt painting of Adam Wainwright.
Seeing all these wonderful people here in the stands, you know, I can't
can't feel a bigger feeling of blessing just in being a St. Louis Cardinal for this long. Being a St. Louis Cardinal at all is a blessing, but to do it for 18 plus years in front of this crowd, in this stadium, in this city, I wouldn't change anything in the world for that. I love y'all so much. Thank you for embracing me. I cannot wait to come back next year and see confetti on this field when the St. Louis Cardinals win a World Series championship. To all the people who came here today, who were up in the suites and down here in these chairs. By the way, Kyle McClellan's here. We missed you earlier. My buddy Kyle McClellan. I love y'all. Thank you so much for supporting me over the years. And guys, I wouldn't have got through these many years, but especially this year, without such an amazing support staff. Y'all don't even know. I've told you a little bit, but the guys in that dugout over there, the coaching staff, our great president, they poured into me in times that I was the lowest of low. They text messaged me late at night, early in the morning, because they couldn't sleep because they cared so much about me and what I was doing. And they believed in me. And they believed in me in times where I couldn't have done it by myself. And so I thank everybody in there and everybody out here who got me through the toughest times of my life for sure. How great is it to see Yadier Molina back out here?
Tell her this all the time, but I fell in love with her in the eighth grade. Isn't that awesome? my oldest daughter, Bailey Grace, who was on the stage here when we won the World Series in 06. My daughter, Morgan. My daughter, Macy. My daughter, Sadie. And my little boy, Caleb. And my little dog, Luke. They're playing the music. Back when it all began, my dad left home when I was 3 years old. My mom raised me up all by herself. She did amazing.
Thank you. forever be gone. I did what I came here to do, and I love being here with you. But I know in my heart that it's time, time to fly.
He's got a great arm, the ball got on me, honestly. First pitch, I wasn't ready.